All right, it's Halloween night, October 31st. This is the meeting of the Conway Board of Selectmen. We are being taped by the Frontier Community Access Television Station for viewing in the future by anyone who is interested in watching the program. First item on the agenda, we have minutes of October 17th. Has everybody reviewed the minutes of October 17th?
Mm-hmm. You look good.
Good.
Any changes or additions? No, I'll make a motion that we approve the minutes for October 17th.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. Next one we have is minutes for the October 24th all committee meeting. And the notes and the minutes are very comprehensive for that meeting. Do we have any changes or additions?
That this meeting also is out on FCAT if people want to watch it.
Right. Yes, it was also
more taped. Interesting viewing than most of our select board meetings.
Yes, it was a very interesting meeting. Yeah,
and good coverage of it in the recorder this morning as well.
Oh.
Yes, only it was very good
this morning.
Conway took up half the paper.
Two articles.
Okay.
Solid article.
All right. Has everybody reviewed the minutes for the all committee meeting? Mm-hmm. Any changes or additions? No? I'll make a motion that we accept the minutes for October 24th.
Second.
All right. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. On October 25th, I could not make that meeting. I know we have minutes for it. Bob, have you reviewed the minutes?
Yes,
you both
back
reviewed
then,
the
yeah.
minutes. Okay. Any changes or additions?
Looks good to me. You're good.
Okay. You want to make a motion?
I'll make a motion that we approve the minutes.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay. All right, next item on the agenda, we have three warrants. We have a vendor warrant for $40,328, payroll warrant for $98,696, and a payroll deduction warrant of $25,599. I'll make a motion that we accept those warrants. Do I have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. Next item on the agenda is meetings attended by select board members since last meeting. Bob, you have anything?
Well, you and I have been busy, so I'll rattle them off. But okay. So we went to the Economic Development Summit with Governor Baker a week and a half ago.
Okay, yeah.
And then we had the all committee meeting this week.
Yeah.
And we had a Selectman's Fall Conference in Worcester on Saturday.
Yeah.
And then one that I went to and that Bob went to, you'll mention this one too, is the Energy Committee had another meeting going over more accurate numbers for the solar array.
So. Right. Okay. I thought the economic development meeting in Worcester back about, let's see, what was it, 2 weeks ago? 2 weeks ago Thursday or two
Wednesday.
Weeks ago Wednesday?
It was on a Wednesday.
Right. I thought that was very useful. You know, the breakout sessions were good. Both Bob and I both attended the Pioneer Valley breakout session, which was good.
I thought that was the best part of it. We got together with just all selectmen from the Pioneer Valley and talked about mm-hmm. stuff local to us.
Yeah. And certainly last week our all committee meeting was right. very comprehensive and I thought people got a good idea of what was going on, and certainly if people in town wanted to watch that, the filming that FCAT did, mm-hmm. it'd be most informative.
Good.
And also on Saturday, there was a Massachusetts Selectmen's Association meeting in at Holy Cross College in Worcester that Bob and I attended, and the keynote speaker was Bob DeLeo, the House Speaker. And that's hosted by Massachusetts Municipal Association. They gave us a legislative update and confirmed that state revenues are not up to expectations at this point. So I had mentioned that at the all committee meeting last week. that we should try to keep our budgets in line with next year because we're not sure what the state's going to do in terms of local and school aid. Although the pledge right now is that that will be unchanged from last year. So, there'll be at least no cuts in it. All right, so that's, but the governor's still got to go through perhaps some 9-3 cuts, some 9C cuts, mm-hmm. so we don't know exactly how that's going to affect our own budgeting process. But yeah, as Bob said, we've been attending meetings all over the place lately. Okay, citizens' concerns. We have any citizens' concerns?
I have one, Bob, to me by the police chief. He's concerned about where our stance on people displaying public advertisement signs on our town commons.
Okay,
and he would like to know what our stand on this.
Well, we have a sign bylaw. So
he's been taking a couple of them down, I guess. But he said, I don't know if I had the right to do that or not. But
now, where are they being displayed?
Mostly on this common.
The triangle up here.
The triangle here.
Yeah.
Okay. What kind of signs?
Well, I don't know. What was the latest one there?
It might be like a no on two or.
No on two. Things like that.
Oh, political signs.
Political signs. Political signs.
Yes.
As opposed to community events.
No.
Mostly political and private. Weddings and.
Well, certainly if somebody wants to put a political sign on their own property, that's their business. But on town property, I'm not sure whether that's in our policies or not. We'll have to check on that.
Yeah.
He would like an answer, so if you could look that up.
You check with our police chief and check our bylaws on it.
There's also a zoning bylaw on signs, too.
Right, yeah.
There's something in the general bylaws, but there is.
We have very specific guidelines for signs, but these are banded signs.
Right. I think actually, if I recall, you're
lawn signs.
One sign pointing to your business, a small sign.
Right.
I think that's about the only thing you really are allowed off premises.
We do have that going on up here in the common, small business on Whaley Road. When they're open, they'll put the sign up there for the day, but they're very good about taking it down that evening and stuff. These seem to get planted up here, and they seem to be forgotten about.
And I know there are often community pool signs or things like that are put up there that are sort of for residents for the public. Mm-hmm. So I would say that would probably be a different category than political signs or business signs. So I'll try to work something up on that.
Well, you said it was a sign, vote no on two. Mm. At the meeting on Saturday, the MMA Director of Communications, John Robertson, gave us an opinion that the board of MMA voted. And MMA is the Massachusetts Municipal Association. They basically represent the towns. They're a liaison with the legislature for presenting matters that the towns are concerned about. And their board voted unanimously on two as well as four. Two is the charter school ballot question. They're recommending a no vote. Speaker DeLeo got up and said he is for a yes vote. And I'm sure you've seen the governor's advertisements that he is also in favor of a yes vote.
On charter schools.
On charter schools, yes.
I'm not sure how he's doing the marijuana question.
And then the other question is the number four, which is, whether recreational marijuana will pass or not. And MMA strongly opposed to a yes vote on that. They want a no vote on that as well. And since we're in the middle of an opioid epidemic, it would seem reasonable that you wouldn't vote for another drug to be legalized, since most people consider it a gateway drug. So that's what MMA had to say on those things on Saturday. Okay. No other citizens' concerns. Okay, next item on the agenda. I guess Catherine and Giselle are not here. I don't see them. So we'll table that for right now. Next item is to sign the letter inviting a descendant of Marshall Field to the 250th anniversary celebration.
We also don't have that ready yet.
We don't have that ready yet. Okay, fine.
I don't think there's any particular rush on that. It's for next spring.
Yeah, okay. We'll table that.
These words that you handed out.
Yeah. I have been expecting a copy in Word that I could cut and paste under the letterhead, but I haven't gotten it.
Okay.
This is a PDF. I can only copy the picture. I can't copy the...
Okay.
I think the committee's still working on it.
I can't format it. Yeah, okay.
All right, our next item is a discussion of the long-term agreement with FCAT.
And this is really just a discussion. I gave you a document. We discussed this a year or so ago.
Right, at the end of last year. Right.
And they want a more formal agreement with the towns that lays some things out. The last time they proposed something, they proposed that the money go directly from Comcast, the money for their operations go directly from Comcast to them. And we took exception to that, and it really should pass through our budget so that we have an accounting of that money internally. And then other things happened, and that effort stalled, I guess, at FCAT.
Right.
They're starting to think about it again. And the last draft that we got included a couple of provisions that I thought were problematic. The first was that FCAT could sell proprietary rights to content, which would include things like select board meetings. And that raises some basic concerns, I think.
Have we had Jack take a look?
Not yet. I gave an initial response. They're looking for, you know, just general responses first, I think. And then I think when they come up with an amended version, we can send that out.
Okay.
They were saying, well, the town could also bid on the video, but if we didn't match the price, then we couldn't buy it. And you know how long it takes.
Can you show us, or show me later where those are?
Yeah, it's in Section 2A. That's Section 2A.
Yeah, just for full disclosure, both Bob and I are on the board of FCAT.
Yeah. And then in Article 9, this is all in the note that I sent on Thursday.
Mm-hmm.
In Article 9, the town would promise to pay FCAT if Comcast doesn't stick to its current 4.8% funding, which on the face of it seems reasonable, but the way that it's written is difficult. First, in order to give them any money, we have to have a town meeting vote on it. And secondly, the way that it's written, if the Comcast percentage were anything but 4.8%, the town would have to pay, towns together would have to pay 60% of FCAT's budget, which can't possibly be the real intent. So that just needs some wordsmithing there.
Mm-hmm.
And I understand they're saying, you know, if the amount they're getting from Comcast falls, you know, they would like the towns to pick up the slack to their current level of funding. And that makes sense, but that's not actually what it says. So I looked at it and raised those couple of points.
I looked at that section and said, but it seems
Conway's percent is nowhere near 4.8.
Quite sketchy the way they worded it.
That's Deerfield, Whately, and Sunderland's percent.
Well, there's another problem with the section.
Yeah, I missed the last board meeting. Did the board vote on this at the last board meeting?
No.
Nothing's happened. Because this is the first time, since Tom sent this out, this was the first time I saw this. So we didn't discuss this at the last board meeting?
No.
Okay.
No, this, and I think this was a second draft of the document that was drawn up a while ago, but is just now starting to come out. I got it from Deerfield.
Okay, so this is actually, you got this from Deerfield.
Yes, and I guess it was a second draft that was being worked on. Of course, that's where Doug went, and it may be that he had it with him. I don't know how the process worked, but this is it's certainly a revised agreement from the one that we had worked on last time.
Yeah, because this is for Deerfield, Conway, Sunderland, and Whately all together.
Doug's not there in Deerfield anymore.
He's gone.
And that yeah. So I it may be that the Deerfield Board of Selectmen wanted to start up the process of talking about it again.
Okay. So when are they looking for some feedback on this?
Well,
I don't know that they are.
I don't know that the Deerfield is. And anyway, I just thought I'd share with you this last version of a proposed agreement, because I don't think that we even saw this one last time. We put in our
we never saw this one.
Yeah, we put in our response to the first one, and my guess is that this was some proposed revision that apparently didn't make it even to the FCAT Board of Directors either. So, but it's later than the other one that we got. So,
all right. So we don't know where this is in there.
No, and we don't need to do anything with it. I just thought I would okay. give it to you because I was requested to.
Okay. Right.
And so you have been informed.
All right.
We should all look it over.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yes.
Especially that article that he just mentioned right here in the article line. Very different.
All right. I think that's enough discussion on this for the night. We'll have to take this up at a later date when we know exactly what's happening with that. Next item is to sign a letter to the owner of dogs that have not been behaving in accordance with
proper behavior.
The rules of Conway. All right, and the letter is addressed to the owner, and it basically says the select board has heard from the town's animal control officer, together with resident complaints, that there have been multiple occasions when dogs that this person owns have been loose and acted aggressively. Okay. And that this person has been warned a number of times by the animal control officer. And the board hears any further complaints. We will hold a hearing under Chapter 140, Section 157 of Massachusetts General Laws, which basically says we can take action against the owner because of the dogs.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Hopefully we can get this worked out without going that far with this.
That's entirely up to the owner.
Yeah.
And this, our animal control officer did approve this letter.
Okay. All right. Everybody has reviewed the letter.
Will this be delivered by Kenny, or?
That was the plan, yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Sounds good to me.
Yeah, I think it's simple and direct enough. I'll make a motion that we sign this letter. Do I have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
My next item on our agenda is being brought to us by the sewer rats. Sign agreement for procurement services for wastewater treatment system design.
You could be the energy rats.
That's right. You could always
back job. Okay, Joe, you're on.
We're here to answer questions, basically. I think you understand. We'd like to go out to bid for engineering services for the sewer system.
Okay.
Or downtown disposal system, some people prefer to call it. And we're contemplating using the FERC card to prepare the bids.
All right. That's a good idea.
Which leads us to the second question we have, which is timing involving either an annual town meeting or a special town meeting. Andrea feels that it would be too early to execute that if it didn't get funded till the town meeting. If we go out to bid, which takes about a month,
okay.
And then we select a contractor,
Right. It probably won't be good for 6 months or 8 months, or, you know, till town meeting. So we're asking if you would consider having a special town meeting, and whenever that selection process is done, to provide us funding. So the idea would be that Andrea would work on that for a month, and we'd send it out, and maybe we'd get it, hopefully two or three bidders, and it would take the sewer rats a month to decide who we would like to go with, and then comes forth the issue of funding it. Mm-hmm. We did talk to the CPA people. They're willing to consider that. Tom had mentioned a community development block grant. I don't know anything about it, although I saw that in one of your...
Well, we certainly included it in our...
Right. So I don't know whether... Or it would just be out of free cash, not free cash, I guess stabilization is what we're talking about. Maybe taking out of one of the stabilization accounts.
We do have money in capital stabilization.
Now, this is, you're talking about to fund the engineering right now.
Yeah, this is just to hire FERCOG,
right,
which is money we have. We're talking about money to hire the engineering. Sort of like what you did with the highway garage.
Sure.
Did you spend, what, $160 or something? Or was it more than that for the highway garage?
My question, I got somewhat serious question about this. How many letters did you send out to the townspeople?
65, I think.
And how many returns did you get back?
About a third of one.
Only one third. You think that one third could afford this project? If they're the only ones that sign up for it at the end?
Not sure I understand your question.
Well, you only got one third response back.
Right. Okay. That's for a better loan grant. That the letter was to see if the townspeople would qualify to receive a grant.
It was asking what their income was.
It was an income survey.
But wasn't it also a survey to ask whether they would be interested in getting in on this system?
I don't believe so. No, it was strictly a household income survey to see if we qualified for the
grants.
USDA grants. There's two funding programs available to USDA. One is a loan program. The other one is a loan plus a grant program. If we had a low enough income and a high enough participation, we would have qualified for a grant. So at this point, the grant is in jeopardy. It was never intended to be, would be a town meeting decision, I guess.
Well, see, I kind of personally interpreted it differently when the letter was sent to me. I thought you were asking for the people's recommendation as to, yeah, I think this is a good idea. I'd be interested in going on with something like that.
So do you have reason to believe there would be low participation? Or high participation?
I don't know what to read into it. We did do a telephone tree. We called people. I got my posterior reamed out by a few people for suggesting that big government should get involved. So, and I did personally deliver some to some of the people in town who didn't understand maybe what it was or didn't appreciate the significance.
I know. I got some comments from my comments on my own, and they were the same as the people that made comments to me about the letters that they were not about to indulge any of their income to anybody.
Right, and that was sort of the comments that we got.
But that has nothing to do with whether they would want to hook up to it.
Right.
I don't know what to read to answer your question. I don't know how many of the non-responses were because they weren't interested.
Well, that's one of my questions. The other ones is, you talked about having two separate systems, one each side of the river.
Yeah.
I know you investigated one area that fell through for the leaching field area. I guess that's what you'd call it, right?
It didn't fall through, but it might not be big enough if you're talking about Jack Lockheed's.
And the other side,
only
the
river, half as big as
the other side of the river, you did not have a location at this point in time.
No, we had the Rose property is where the testing was. The site that was evaluated was the Rose property.
I thought you were one of Mr. Lockheed's you investigated.
We did that, right. On that side of the river was Jack Lockett.
Okay.
On this side was the Rose property.
Because I know you had mentioned something.
Town Park.
You had mentioned something about a parcel of land downstream further on that other side of the river. Didn't you?
I don't recall.
Things like that were discussed.
We certainly did look at Harris's. We talked to singulars.
So you
they weren't interested.
You have no locked in areas yet then? Or feasible areas at this point?
Well, one we hope is the Town Park.
Okay. Yeah. And then I guess my final question on this would be, do you think we're putting the cart ahead of the horse here by saying let's go out with an engineering study. We don't know if the people in this community are even going to want to buy this thing. Buy this plan.
How would you propose we tackle that?
I think we should have a special town meeting or go to a special town meeting and ask the residents what they think of it. Are they going to back this or not?
Price.
I mean, if they're not going to back it, why are we wasting money engineering?
How are we going to find out if they'll back it if we don't have a price? We gave you, all we signed up for initially was a feasibility study to see if it was technically feasible. Okay. And then we presented that at town meeting. We now, within the scope of that article, we want to go and hire Andrea Woods to go out to bid for an engineering firm. That would be the first big financial step, just like you did with the highway.
And that's for the
grant
money?
I don't recall people voting on the highway garage before they funded the engineering. They funded the engineering study, and then they turned it down when they got the final answer.
Okay. But they were asked to fund the engineering study.
That's what we're going to ask for. Had a special town meeting. Right now, all we're asking for is you to sign the contract so we can have Andrea prepare a bid package. When she... help me out, guys.
Yeah,
all right, let me back up. We got $12,000 to a feasibility study to see if it could be done. The answer seems to be yes, with some reservation. Within that same article, we want to spend $1,000 to prepare a bid package for the engineering. Select an engineer, then go back to special town meeting and see if the people want to fund the engineering for a downtown sewer system. Which
is
exactly what you did with the
selection process for the engineering.
Exactly.
This is to select an engineer.
Okay.
But we'd like not to wait until regular town meeting to find out if you want to fund it, then it'll be another year before we go back to another town meeting. So we're hoping, what we're asking for is if you would consider a special town meeting. So that once we get the bids and we know what the engineer is going to cost, we go back to special town meeting and ask for the funding. If they say
and
no,
there'll probably be time between getting the engineering done, getting a price, and taking that to the spring town meeting.
That would be for the construction.
For the construction
of a wastewater disposal system.
Yeah,
that would be our hope, that we could hire an engineer and get the engineering done and go out to bid for a town sewer, if the people want to.
So what we're looking for now is to sign this, to put a bid package together.
That's exactly
okay.
Yeah.
Right. But we're also asking for a consideration for a special town meeting.
Well, certainly if you get bids in, we're going to have a special town meeting, because the bids won't be for 6 or 8 months.
So
they'll
Andrew's
be for a shorter
saying,
period.
If you're not going to have a special town meeting, we should hold off on this project until, you know, closer to town meeting.
I would think.
Well, your recommendation is to do this now.
Yes.
And the rest of the sewer rats agree with you.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
And how bad is everyone's septic tank actually getting? I don't remember.
Some people are on their third, some are on their fourth.
Nobody's without one though, right?
Nobody's without one.
So, well, yeah.
There hasn't been, I guess, a lot of water contamination. There's been a lot of water dry up.
Yeah.
And those people are drilling deep wells.
I just can't see the what the problem would be holding off to the annual town meeting. It's not that far away. We're already near the end of the year right now. I mean, you're talking by the time you get something scheduled, you're going to be in on January and sometime to get the special town meeting in board.
Probably
with the holidays and something. So that's going to put
that
you,
would be,
you know,
after the holiday.
I personally think we're just wasting our money doing that. I think we should wait to the regular annual.
What would it cost us to do this right now? Do we know?
That's $1,000.
$1,000. Okay. So we're spending $1,000 to put a bid package together, to get bids from engineers to go to the next step.
Well, we need to resolve the timing issue as well.
Yeah.
Do you have an actual...
If you don't support a special town meeting, we need to talk to Andrea and find out if we should delay this study, this bid process.
Do you have any pretty concrete ideas what it costs us to put on a special town meeting? You don't mind this $1,000 spend over here on this?
It's mostly paying
for the mailing.
There's a mailing, and you have to pay for registering. You have to have a day where you register voters 2 weeks in advance of that, and that's coverage for 12 hours, I think, or something like that.
So you don't have an actual figure then?
No, it's several. I would put it at somewhere between $1,000 and $5,000. It's probably between $1,000 and $3,000.
$1,000 to put on a special town
meeting? Jenny used to budget for one special town meeting. I don't know if she still does that.
Yeah, she does.
I thought it was in the high hundreds.
It's certainly
in the 800.
Yeah, it's, you think it is.
Yeah.
It's closer to 1,000.
Close to 1,000. Yeah, I didn't want to underestimate it.
Do we have anything else that's driving a special town meeting?
Frontier has asked for repurposing some money so that they can fund their move to Frontier, to the high school itself.
So that's not costing anything. Just, I remember when that came up here. Yeah.
Yeah, that's just a formality vote for the transfer of the paperwork.
Well, to repurpose money that the town had given them for one thing to another purpose.
They're already spending the money doing this.
The money is already allocated.
Allocated, right. So that's not...
Right.
It's not raising any money.
Right.
Well, I would say sign it and then get back to us on your feelings on a special town meeting.
Well, I think certainly this is our first step, and... you're recommending this. You've done work on it. It's $1,000 to put a bid package out. I think that's reasonable.
For that portion, is probably.
Yes. Yeah. And then we can move to the next step or wait. Okay. Any other discussion? Okay. I'll make a motion that we sign the contract with FERCOG for procurement services for wastewater treatment system design in the amount. It's going to cost us $1,000 to do that. Put out a big package for engineers. Do I have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
You going to tie this to the special town meeting?
Well, we'll get bids back first, and then
we'll talk about the town meeting after.
We'll see if the town meeting.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Okay.
To address your question, Bob, we need to be sensitive to the people that have already spent money. I went and talked to Fran Garacci. You know, they spent $65,000 on that system after they paid off their mortgage. Mm-hmm. So now they're paying for a septic system. You've got Mark Silverman, who's
spent $35,000.
And probably other people that I don't know about. So we need to take that into account. We still think we need a sewer system, but we need to figure out what's fair for everybody. And, you know, that's something we're going to have to struggle with and trying to figure out. Some towns do what's called a checkerboard. Certain people go in, certain people go out. That is allowed by the law. So but we have to figure out, you know, what happens if their system does fail and they haven't paid in. There are certainly challenges in...
The reason, I'll tell you what was driving a lot of this. I had a discussion with another community very close to Conway, where they just went through this a few years ago. And they still got fighting going on there when they come to the regular town meetings, because they had such a dissension in the community about the septic system. This is probably 10 years ago now. That they're still fighting on town meeting floors about it. And these people have gotten to the point that didn't want it, and it went through, that they're barking all everything else happening in the town. And I just don't want to see that take place in Conway.
And I'd hate to see the center of town go down the drain, so to speak.
Or down the sewer.
Sewer rats.
Okay.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Thank you, Joe.
Thank you, Joe.
You'll give me a copy of that one.
And thank the rest of your wastewater committee.
Thank you.
Okay.
You're next. Sorry, it's past 6 o'clock. Wake up.
Okay, next item on the agenda is to sign engineering services agreement for redesign of Green Communities project. Bryce, what do we got?
Two invoices. One of which is what Lily has mapped out for doing a energy audit, blower door, and energy analysis for the town garage, which we talked about doing, shifting some of the money that we were working on the town, town hall to also accommodate that. And then the other one is for the engineers, mechanical engineers, time and materials on this.
Okay, so the first one is labeled proposal for the Conway Town Hall Building Efficiency.
Right.
EIFS scope.
I guess I don't got that one.
No.
You got that?
No, I got the other one. I see this one.
The town graduate.
That's it, yeah.
Right, there's one that's new. It comes under the same.
I don't know how that.
Same item. It just came in. That's the $1,500 one?
Yes, $1,474. Total additional fee requested for the funding.
That's the time and materials one.
Yeah, for the town graduate.
You get three copies?
Mm-hmm. We don't have his copy.
Oh.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Can we get copies of that?
Yeah, one of those is for you. Oh, yeah, this one.
I have that. This is the town graduate.
Well, we don't have copies.
We don't have the town hall one. Anyway.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is the.
Sorry.
We have just the highway
this
garage.
This is the other one. That's the time and materials. This is the building efficiency for town hall right here. This one.
That's where we need the town hall one. We got this one. Town highway garage.
Okay.
So it's that one there we need town right there.
So essentially, we've shifted some of the money from town hall to the town garage.
That's what we're planning on doing. Okay. So the contractor is already contracted with us, can keep working, mm-hmm. and accommodate, do some change the focus of this to take care of some things both in the town hall, but as well as to be also be able to start on doing the town garage.
So that's this first one?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. And the second one is for the actual materials?
Basically, yes, for doing the, that one is for doing the audit, if you will, of the building and
the blower doors.
Right, and doing a recommendation as to what needs to be done to the town garage. And the scope of the doors is not included in this, since that is something that's doing separate. The scope of the town hall door, the town garage new door,
yeah.
That's separate. Not be part of this. We found out that those doors are, as like you said, we're told by the contractor, are excellent as way of insulation and just the needs more effective air sealing. So.
While he's making copies, let me ask some questions about this town garage one.
Yeah.
Can you explain the difference between the 59 and the 65? Speed of conking, whatever that is. C-O-N-T-I-N-G?
Right.
Oh, yeah, it's not clear what the columns mean.
Yeah.
I can get that clarified for you. I think it's just looking at this.
My question there, would both these figures be added together? Or
no.
just this was the original figure 59 plus something else to bring the grand total up to 6,500?
Yeah, I think it's more of a range. Mm-hmm.
Yes, it's a range of 5943 to 6537.
It's like the last column is the previous column with a little adder. You know, $5 added, $25 added. Okay. Like 10%. I don't know, is that what goes to FERCOG or something like that, maybe? Is it somebody apply a 10% tax is what it looks like?
That's a great question, and I can't answer that right now.
Contingency.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, that's so there's a 10% contingency that's added to it.
It doesn't say contingent, but that's right.
Well, it could.
Continge.
Contingency.
Yeah, that's a reasonable range.
Yeah, 10%, right?
Yeah. Any other questions for Bryce on that?
So this is all what we talked about in, was it the last meeting?
Right.
2 meetings ago? We talked about all these things.
Yes, and
this is all what we talked about the gymnasium that morning, too.
That's right.
And again, that the larger one is the engineering services for the redesign.
Mm-hmm.
The second one, she calls a change order one because it's engineering time and materials for the change order itself rather than her services. This is her services to change what Matt Gosselin will do. Our contract with him.
Right. Okay.
So, and she's calling that a change order. It's part of a change order. It's a change order, but it's a change order for, it's going to only affect her. She's going to write the change order for him, which would be the second change order for the project.
Yeah.
Okay. This is her part of the deal.
Any other questions for Tom or Bryce on this? All right. And this is recommended to us by the Energy Committee?
Yes.
Okay. I'll make a motion that we sign the proposal for Conway Town Hall Building Efficiency EIFS Scope, Change Order 1, and also the proposal for the Conway Highway Garage Energy Audits, Blower Door, IR, Bin Analysis and Report. Have a second?
Second it.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you.
Thank you, Bryce. You guys do a tremendous job.
Forward.
Forward. We're going forward, right?
That's right. Have a great evening.
Thanks.
Happy Halloween.
Do you need any of these signed copies?
No.
Okay.
I'll take care of that.
Alrighty, thank you all. Have a good night.
Thanks, Bryce.
Enjoy it.
Have a good night.
Yep.
Signing this, would you start the fiscal 2018 budget discussion?
Yes, I put this on at Robert Baker's request. I believe you had you asked me to put that on, so I'll just turn it over to you.
Well, last year, of course, my first fiscal year of selectmen, I felt that because of lack of knowledge of all the budgets, I didn't have an accurate enough information to willingly feel like I wanted to vote for him. Because I don't think the Board of Selectmen have enough input into it. I mean, Tom does a wonderful job of it, but that's as far as it goes. We just get a bottom line dollar figure to vote on. And I would like to stay in touch with the town communities in the different departments to find out what they're going to be doing this next year. And what entails in their budget. So that, to me, would be, I'd like to be involved with, I think, myself, I think the select board should somehow get better involved with the budget process like they did in the past bunch of years, where they used to come in and meet with the boards and the town administrator all at once. And so we get a real true understanding of what their budgets are entailing.
And what has happened since I've been here, which is not very
prior
long either.
Yeah, right, a year prior to me, yep.
Has been that when all of the departments have submitted their budget requests, then I put those together and give them to the Select Board and the Finance Committee. And out of that, the Select Board and the Finance Committee can request any department to come in and discuss a budget. And of course, there are some that are just one line. You know, Council on Aging gets $400. Not too much to discuss about that. On the other hand, the Highway Department almost always comes in, or has always come in since I've been in here, because it's the largest non-school item in the budget. Sometimes the sometimes the Finance Committee has requested the Ambulance Department to come in to talk about things. Their system of funding is fairly complicated, and the way that we deal with that is unusual. So it helps to have some clarity on that. So it really is up to the board and the Finance Committee who they would like to invite between the time we have a budget and the time you need to, you know.
Last year we had all major budgets in, didn't we?
I think so. Mm-hmm. Public Works and Public Safety, I would.
Some of the small ones we just let Finance Committee recommend, or we let Tom talk to those particular committees or boards and work out their budgets that way.
And I had presented on my own budget.
Mm-hmm. Now, sometime prior to that, they've all gone over their budget with the Finance Committee.
No.
No?
No. The first year I was here, we had the Public Safety and Public Works invited to present to the Select Board first, because you're their direct overseers, to get on what I saw it as is getting on the same page before the board and the departments they oversaw presented to the Finance Committee, so that the board had already gone through all of the knotty parts and understood everything and was prepared to defend the department's request to the Finance Committee. That had not been the way it had been done prior to that, and there was some desire expressed by the Finance Committee to have everyone meet at the same time so everyone was getting all the same information.
That's what we used to do.
So
and it was an extremely time-consuming process. Because we were going over line item by line item in each budget, and we'd started a 7 o'clock budget meeting, and we'd be out of here at 11:30 at night because of all the minutiae we were going through. So the process that Tom initiated was a process that was probably more efficient and less time consuming on the select
on the board.
You know.
But that same token, as a board member, there was questions that I had on different budgets that even Tom couldn't answer, so he'd have to go back to the boards again. And I'm too old school, I guess. I've been here 30 some odd years, presented our budget to this Board of Selectmen for 35 years, and we always met with the Finance Committee, the Select Boards, and the Town Administrator or Town Selectman Secretary, whoever it might have been at the time, and everybody heard everything exactly at the same time. And there was changes made. Sometimes there was none. John, you were here.
Sure.
Back then.
Yeah.
And I always thought there was a wonderful way to do it. Everybody knew it. Everybody stood around the table at one point. Well, now you don't get that anymore.
Well, was there a particular budget that you didn't particularly understand last year or didn't like?
Well,
or
had questions? There's a bunch of them I had questions on, but, you know, how can you really, without the person that put the budget together, how can you really... I don't know, get the proper answer. I understand what Tom's doing. Tom's trying to lighten our load, but it leaves blank spots in my mind with me.
All right, well, what we can do this year is any time that we have questions that require those committees to come in, we'll do that. We'll do that.
And that's always been the case. You know, you can always ask people to come in and talk about their budgets. It's just a question of whether we do it separately or together. And I know the Finance Committee would prefer to have it together, which is what we did last year. The year before that, My idea was to have things go more smoothly when we met with the finance committee.
So all of the initial
questions were already worked out, more that we wouldn't be wasting their time.
So now you got the department heads coming back in for more than one meeting?
Yes.
Where before you never did. Never had to.
Well, most of them, though,
might not have to come in.
It's a question of whether it's one long meeting or two shorter meetings.
When I'll talk specifically for myself. When I have a question about some department's budget, and I don't care whose it is, I want to meet with a person to put the budget together. I don't want to ask Tom the question. I don't want Tom to have to go back and chase after the question. I prefer to ask her right to the person to put the budget together. How much closer do you get than that?
And that's always been the way it's been done.
Mm-hmm. Years past, right.
Either way that we've been talking about it, mm-hmm. you can always request someone to come in and talk about their budget. Mm-hmm.
All right, so why don't we go, you know, we'll have a first run on budgets, and then those things that we have questions on, we'll have those people come in. Does that work?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh. Once they have their budget kind Absolutely. Of done, how long do we have until we have to...
Well, we've started the budget process a lot earlier than we had in the past, right. So we do have okay. more time.
We used to get right down the wire before.
Right.
I
mean,
I think you got a draft schedule.
Okay, it's in here.
We do?
Yeah, you should have.
I didn't see one.
I didn't see one.
That's it.
Yep, there it is.
Budget countdown.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry. Yeah, that's... Oh, right. There it is. There it is. That's the schedule on the back, right?
So that's proposed.
Okay.
Yeah, because remember we used to have our town meeting the second Monday in April.
Right.
So that cut us down a whole month. Now we have it in May, it gives us an extra month.
And we gave people until 5 weeks before town meeting to get to have the budget finalized.
Sure. It was in the packet.
So now it's two months, which is still tight.
Yeah.
If you look at those last few weeks, it's very, very tight.
Yeah.
This might have been in what Tom sent out that I printed off of his email.
Oh, was it in the emails you sent us, or was it in this packet tonight?
I have both of them to get mixed together, and it's hard for me to know which is which. So you might have sent this out only in the email.
You have this?
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't have it.
Oh, you don't have it?
It says memorandum.
Here. I have two. Oh. So this is basically the schedule that Tom has put together for this year's budget process. And I thought last year worked very well in terms of the timing, in terms of getting things done in time. We had always been pressured in the past to the last minute to get stuff done.
And I just want to make sure we all know, or I know the budget well enough that I could defend it on town meeting floor.
Well, it'll take some time, Bob.
Yeah, I understand.
don't think you can do that this year.
Okay.
Oh, and...
Again, it would be easy if you sat through them all, because you know them all exactly the way they were. But we don't seem to want to do that anymore, so that's right. We'll go with the flow.
Well, it depends, you know, how much detail we want at our level. How much detail we want Tom to take care of in the finance committee and the individual committees. So we'll work that out as we go along.
Right. And you can, you know, if you want somebody to come in, you can always ask them in.
Okay.
But we'll get complete copies of their budgets, correct?
Oh, yeah. Absolutely. Okay. Sure. Yeah, we'll get a whole budget book.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay.
Tom, you have anything else on that?
I don't, no.
Okay. So we have your schedule. All right.
And that's draft. You know, you can,
right. Oh, yeah, sure.
Give me comments on it. I do intend to send it out sometime within the next week or two.
Okay.
Right. Next item, which is a very important item that Dave brought up at the meeting the other night, is our volunteer situation. And Dave suggested that we do some kind of a volunteer recruitment program, which I think is a great idea because... you know, we're wanting for volunteers, and every other town out there is wanting for volunteers. We heard some of that at the select board meeting on Saturday.
That, and church groups and civic organizations and hospitals a lot of competition.
Exactly, and you know, people are spread very thin between work and what they do otherwise. And, you know, it seems like we don't have the spirit of volunteerism as has been in the past. But certainly what I'd like to do, it you know, based on Dave's suggestion, is, you know, we need to form some sort of a program to get people more interested in
town affairs.
Yeah, in understanding that things run basically, you know, aside from our staff that does a great job and works very hard and is very dedicated, we need a whole lot of volunteers to keep things going in town, as do all small and certainly larger communities here in the Commonwealth. So why don't you, you know, poll other town administrators, ask them what they're doing in terms of volunteer programs, and we'll formulate something that we can roll out in the next 3 or 4 months, and maybe get a big push for at the annual town meeting to have more people, you know, come into the process, because it's getting harder and harder. Many of the volunteers that we have now in town are getting older and looking for the next level to come in and kind of take over some of those responsibilities and duties that they've practiced for the last umpteen years. So let's see what we can do about putting a program together. And certainly, Dave, anything that you have that you can discuss with Tom in that vein would be, you know, certainly welcome. Because it's a tremendous point. We need to get more volunteers in every aspect of town government. You know.
I wonder what we could do for recognition. You know, when Malcolm came in the other day and thanked the board, you, for
it was all of us. It was Tom's idea.
Okay, I'll give it to Tom. Yeah. But I think he was truly honored.
He was.
He has spoken to me personally. Yes, he is. And you know,
the amount of time a lot of people put in, often without any recognition, mm-hmm. is tough.
It's very important to give our volunteers more recognition.
Well, one of the things that we've started is recognizing people in their 5 and 10 year anniversaries, but that's mostly. Mostly staff that we're doing that for, because we don't have good records for the committees, so we could think of something like that as well.
Absolutely, yeah. Because again, that's a very important discussion and program that we need to implement. Dave, do you have any other comments?
I have a lot of other comments, but they're probably they can wait until Tom and I can talk. Tom and I have had some conversations about it, and I would just broaden what you said to not only towns, but there are some, as I mentioned last Monday, there are some organizations around that have some good volunteer organizations, mm-hmm. That are well managed and always challenges for sure. But they have programs. They do recognize people. They have a strategy, a written strategy. They've got the details of a plan that has to do with websites. It has to do with marketing brochures and publications. That has to do with an aim to help citizens, in our case, the citizens in Conway, understand what opportunities are available to them. Mm-hmm. I don't know of any. Now and then we will see things on the website saying, well, these committees need some volunteers. But I don't know if very many people understand what's involved. For some, there might only be 2 meetings a year, mm-hmm. Like the planning the zone board of appeals. Mm-hmm. For others, it's training. It's putting out money. For others, there's a stipend.
Yes.
And that's a closely held secret, as far as I know. I've been in town 35 years, and it's a very closely held secret where it could be a motivator, mm-hmm. for some people to get involved. So it's not just contacting and seeing and putting stuff on the internet or putting it in the visitor, but it is to
to be clear about what these jobs, what these opportunities involve, and what the payback is. Mm-hmm. Because there is payback, sure. But no one really understands, I think, not a lot of people understand what the benefits are of participating in a, in this mm-hmm. case, a municipal organization.
Well, to me, a successful one in town is the fire department.
Yes.
You have an active kids program that, you know, is doing great, and a good number of firemen. And the ambulance is struggling.
Mm-hmm. I think if there's only one thing that we could lay on the table tonight, it is to have someone who's responsible for this.
Mm-hmm.
If none of us are really considered to be our jobs, then it's just going to be happenstance. It's going to happen willy-nilly.
The fire department might be a little bit different than some of the other organizations, but we're our key objective of the fire department, and it's worked out very well for many, many years, is if you have people come to your, interested in your committee, whatever you got going on, and they sit there and just talk, you're going to lose them.
Yep.
Our goal at the fire department has always been get these people in there. If they got interest enough that they want to come and look and sign up, thinking they might be on mission, let's get them right in immediately, hands on. Mm-hmm. The more stuff they can get their hands on, the more things they can be doing, the more interested they're going to be in coming back.
Mm-hmm. Being involved, part of the team.
Being involved.
Right. And that, to me, not only that, I mean, every Wednesday you have a training program. Right. So people are not only volunteering to, you know, go to all of the fires, they every Wednesday they go down
and learn, hopefully learn
and
something new.
Learn something new. Right. It's like asking them to do more,
right.
But I think it's helping attract them.
Oh, granted, we lose a few once in a while, not too many, but as a rule, it's worked out very well.
Tom, do you know Lindsay Jacobson?
I don't.
From HCOG?
No.
Hampshire Council of Governments. She runs the RSVP program, which is the Retired Senior Volunteer program.
Mm-hmm.
She's got about 300 volunteers, and she motivates people to be involved in their program.
Yeah.
I'll get you her contact information, and maybe you can, you know, talk to her, and maybe she can give you some ideas on how she does what she does. And she's runs a very successful program.
Well, there's probably a lot of seniors in this town that have a lot of great ideas mm-hmm. in their minds, but nobody's ever asked them for any information on it, so they don't feel they want to indulge you.
Just doing a survey. We don't need another survey, perhaps, but maybe having someone just telephone and say, hey, we've got some interesting opportunities for you, mm-hmm. What might you be interested in? It's reaching out, I think,
sure.
taking the initiative,
yeah.
and having a focus, which I think we're lacking right now, is the focus, and that being, you know, it's kind of ironic that it would be good to have a single person in charge of building this program, but the problem is getting the volunteer to build the program and volunteers, but I think it can be done.
But I think it's certainly something that we need to focus on.
Well, I thank you for responding to my outburst on Monday night.
It's very important. It was a great point, and everybody understood that.
It was an elephant in the room situation.
Oh, absolutely, absolutely. Yeah, and you know, thank you for that.
With all of the people in the room commenting on the two or three committees that they're that they're part of.
Right.
If we had more volunteers, maybe they wouldn't need to be on two or three committees.
Yes, that's the point. Absolutely.
That's the point.
Exactly, and then they don't get burned out.
And they could do a better job in the committee's room.
Yes.
Because they wouldn't be burnt out.
Tom, do we have any items non-anticipated in 48 hours?
I don't have anything else, no.
Okay. You have an update for us, Tom?
A very brief one.
Well, it's Halloween. I know you have to get out there and go trick-or-treating.
Go to the
now that I've grown my mask. I'm sad to report that the Board of Health phone, along with mine and Lisa's, are still out. Cracker does not stock the desk units, which I find unacceptable in a company providing telephone service. I am working with Roy to assess our options, and I believe I can find a competitive price that will come with appropriate customer service.
Yeah, how long have those phones been out?
The Board of Health, more than a week.
That's not acceptable.
Mine and Lisa's almost a week. It will be a week by the time we get to
this.
You know, if we have a phone go down, we should have a phone the next day to replace that phone.
That's my feeling.
You know.
We are in the final phase of the audit required to begin the borrowing process for a new fire truck. We expect the final results of the audit to be released within the next 2 weeks.
Good. Okay.
The treasurer and accountant are requesting the select board to consider moving your meeting night to Tuesdays. There is a very tight turnaround to process the warrants, and the payroll warrant in particular, which has to wait till Monday due to weekend hours being worked. So they are often running around pulling their hair out on a Monday, trying to get everything done in time. They put it out there, and I'm bringing it to you. We have been able to manage it. It is very tight sometimes, and it's...
Isn't the accountant only in here for 1 day a week?
Yep.
So how's that going to affect her if we went to Tuesday night? Well, she's not going to come in Tuesday?
She'd come in on a Tuesday.
Oh, well, so she's still going to have the same problem?
No, because we would have Monday to process...
Well, you mean the stuff that
warrant.
She's processing isn't getting to her in time that day that she does it? Is that what it is?
Jan has to process payroll,
mm-hmm.
and then she has to get it to the accountant.
On the same day that they're both doing it?
Yes.
So in other words, the problem isn't so much with the accountant. It's mostly with the
payroll
department
warrant.
Getting it to
well,
stuff there.
Which is something that happens between the two
of them. Right, I understand.
So it's with both of them. Right.
Okay.
So that's just something to think about.
Mm-hmm.
I will also note that there are a number of Monday holidays, so we have to meet on a Tuesday anyway.
Right.
So I don't know how all of your schedules work, but it just came up. Didn't have time to talk with you individually about it yet, so...
Okay. Or we can think about it, I guess.
Yeah, we'll take it under advisement, yeah.
It's hard because many of us are on a lot of other committees that
right.
now meet on Tuesdays because we're here Mondays.
That's true, yeah.
Well, and I fully understand that. And this may be a sort of a long-term request, but if you could all give that some thought,
sure.
and maybe get back to me with pros and cons, then I can start to shape a timeline or a
okay.
or not.
What time on Mondays does the accountant normally go home? Leave here to go home. If their job's done, they're going home.
Anywhere from 2 to 4.
So say it's 2 o'clock.
Depends on how.
Say it's 2 o'clock. Jan don't come in till 9 o'clock in the morning. She's going to compile the complete payroll. Get it to her so she can get it all processed before she gets out of here 2 o'clock. So I can understand there's a wicked tight situation here.
And there's often a little hiccup.
Oh, a little bit glitch, sure.
Yeah.
Okay. Is there any way of rearranging our treasurer's and the accountant's hours so that works a little better?
The problem is that people work weekend hours. So
right.
She can't do any of the work on Friday. It's the payroll. So, aside from coming in on a Sunday, which probably...
Yeah, well, no, I'm not talking about coming in on a Sunday. If she came in earlier on a Monday and the accountant came in a little later on a Monday, there'd be more time in there. Is that a possibility?
Well, I don't... A matter of an hour, maybe even two, it could help in some cases, but it's taking up the whole day, more or less.
Mm-hmm.
And
in other words, what you're saying is the process that Jan has to do is taking more up more than the whole Monday that she's here. to get it ready, basically ready, to get it to the accountant and everything else.
Well, she needs 2 days to get the stuff ready. When she can. If there are problems, then she's not getting it to the accountant until 2 o'clock, who then stays till 4.
And on Monday.
Yeah. And so it can be a very close call, more or less. And it has been a few times. It's usually not that bad, but it's a focal point of pressure for them. I'll put it that way.
And
sometimes it's not that bad.
So the warrants.
And sometimes an hour or two might be fine to deal with it. Sometimes
the warrants include payroll that includes the weekend.
Yes. And
so then, for so us to be signed earlier Monday, Monday night is very tight. And if we didn't have
it has been at times. Tuesday. Yes.
We'll have to think about it and see what we can do.
Yeah. Okay. Next item: concerns of our selectmen. Do we have any concerns? No concerns. Okay. I don't see any mail. I don't see any announcements. Our next meeting is Monday the 7th
at
7 p.m. here in the town offices.
Yeah. 1 second. Just checking. Yes, actually, there is some mail. Sorry.
Oh, there is some mail. Okay. Yeah. Let's see what we got here. Okay, I knew about this. The second biennial regional legislative summit is being rescheduled for December the 3rd. I think it was the 17th of November. They rescheduled it for December the 3rd. And I'm sure we're going to get more notice on that.
Yep. Okay. We did get a notice about that.
We did, but it's been changed.
Yeah.
They didn't change it.
Yeah.
Modern wood heat presentation and tour from municipal officials on December the 2nd. That's in the Ulver Transit Center at FERCOG in Greenfield. Did you guys see that?
Some of those may be old from last week.
Yeah, that's old. Here we got, we have come drive an electric vehicle. Well, you don't have to do that because you're almost
not
there.
Not yet.
Yeah. at the Dalton Senior Center.
We got that too.
Next Wednesday from 1 to 3.
We get that in emails.
Yep.
Okay. You got that?
Yep.
Okay.
Well, if it comes in for you guys, I put it in
No,
there.
No, it's good.
No, we got your email sent to us. There's something about the emails you sent us or something about it.
Okay.
Everything else in here is old.
Okay.
Great.
Bob, let me have that one back.
Okay.
And also, just a reminder that there are some things, like when Comcast changes its service structure, I put in the other, there's another purple folder back there, and you can look through those anytime you want. There are things that, you know, this is something that Comcast will mail out to all of its subscribers, and we just get a copy, but since it comes in for you, I have a place for it in there. It's just not something that necessarily is news, I'll put it that way, newsworthy.
So our next meeting is Monday the 7th. Next Monday, let's be prepared to do an executive session for reason 7.
Yep.
Okay. Good. Is there any other business to come before the board? I know you guys are anxious to go out and trick or treat.
Put your costumes on.
Yeah. I'll make a motion that we adjourn.
Second.
All right, all in favor?
Aye.
Okay.